Hello folks, I have a video about replacing a Pure Plus refrigerator filter. And if you've been having problems with yours like I have with mine, hopefully this video helps you out. This is only my second time replacing the Pure Plus filter on my refrigerator. My refrigerator is only a little over a year old. So let me show you what I'm talking about here. If this is like yours, and you pull this down, and you pull down the filter, unscrew this one, and then put the new one in, and screw it in, and you're finished, at least that's what the instructions say you can do, then you're in the same boat that I've been in, most likely, or a similar one. So, the first time I tried to replace the filter, followed all the instructions, put this one in, did the turn, put it back up, right? Well, it won't stay back up without that door. So, it would not stay on when I would actually go through and do the cycle where you're supposed to do the gallon or so of water to flush everything out. The filter would just pop off. Tried for maybe a day or so. And then we went through our warranty, got the warranty technician to come out. Took him half an hour. He put his whole body into it. And he told me that, you know, you have to use a lot of force. Well, turns out that advice was not specific enough for me. So one thing that people keep saying, so here's the drawer I took out to make room for it. Here's the original, you can see here, this is an LG filter. And then this is a third party one that costs considerably less. It just says Pure Plus on here. And the problem was that I put it on, it would keep popping off. And even before the technician came out, I tried putting the old filter back on, and I couldn't get that one back on either. So the whole argument that if you use the more expensive original one, you won't have a problem versus any third party one that comes in packs of three or even more, I don't buy it. So what I ended up doing here was I turned this, and let me show you up in here. I turned it so hard clockwise that the housing, let me show you. So this circular housing right here, right? This whole thing. I turned it so hard that this housing also turned clockwise, and that helped. That actually worked. Now the problem with that is I don't know what's going to happen next time. I don't know if I actually damaged it or not, but I would want to demonstrate for you, but I feel like it's too risky. I'm going to wait until the next time I need to replace this filter before I try my technique again. So good luck to you guys. But what worked for me this particular time was making sure that the entire housing that is housed in, now it's beeping because it's telling me to close the door. The entire housing that it's housed in closes also. So good luck out there, folks.